In the criminal justice system, rat-based offenses are considered especially heinous in New York City. The dedicated detectives who investigate these vicious felonies are members of an elite squad known as the Special Red Unit. These are their stories.
All right, team. I have a very important announcement to make. Recently, there has been a string of murders in Manhattan, all of which have taken place in our most beloved bakeries.
So you're telling me somebody is going around murdering all the bakers in Manhattan?
That's right, Ice-T, someone is. Sarah Lee was found dead in the kitchen last week.
Shit! I'm Ice-T, and that's messed up.
That's right, Ice-T, it is. Soon after, Ezekiel and Mr. Orowee went missing. We've been looking for them since Monday.
Anyway, this would normally not be the case the unit would take on. However, we have brought in a special consultant to help us with this case. Who is it?
Theo!
This is the joy for me. I love crime. I now just manage it. I don't deny myself crime. I solve crime every day. That's the genius of this program. I solve 26 crimes, and I manage to get taste some nutty, seedy crime every single day.
So you're telling me Oprah Winfrey is gonna help us solve this case?
She is. If anyone knows how to devour bread and how to solve crime, it's her.
That's pretty cool.
Alright, team, I wish you the best of luck. Catch me a
murderer. Dun dun! A two-way
mirror.
So, tell us a bit about your bread business.
Well, I am the founder and co-owner of Udi Gluten Free.
Oh, gluten free bread, just arrest him right now!
No, Elliot, while it is absolutely disgusting, we need to keep our personal opinions out of this.
Okay.
Where were you between the hours of 9 and 10 last Monday morning?
As always, I was in the factory making my well-loved gluten-free bread. Ask Mrs. Jip. She worked at the factory across the street, and she could see me the whole time. Same goes for Mr. Orowee.
Can't be him. We've got an eyewitness account. There's no way he could have committed this crime.
Olivia, you should know by now, after all the cases you've been through, eyewitnesses are never reliable.
What? So you're telling me that eyewitness accounts aren't consistently reliable?
Yes.
She.
Mrs. Chip, how's my relationship with the bread baker in the town? Without you noticing? No secret entrances or exits?
Not that I know of. But I wouldn't put it past him. Those gluten-free people have no morals.
Thank you, Miss Jim. That's enough. Let us know if you find any new information. Our last suspect is Dave from Dave's Killer Bread. Recently got out of jail.
And whoa, so you're telling me a prisoner is making bread?
Yes!
She. Why were you in jail in the first place?
Well, I got into a bit of a skirmish with the owner of Boudin Bread. Well, I was on vacation in San Francisco. I had a couple of beers and he said his bread factory made the best bread, and well...
I see, so you had trouble with alcohol in the past.
Well, yeah.
And this has led to violent tendencies when you insult people, insult your bread company?
Well,
and
yeah.
And so it would be completely out of the question for you to murder, I don't know, say Sarah Lee? For her comments about your rivalry?
No, that's absurd.
What about Ezekiel and Mr. Orwin? You have publicly stated that they're the reason for the decline in the bread business. And you'd be happy if they stopped breathing.
I wanted them dead. Yes. But I promise
It wasn't me who killed them.
Are you sure, Eli?
I'm not guilty. I swear.
Look under your seat.
Oh. I bet it says otherwise! Guilty! Not yours, I see. You get something special.
What do you mean? This just says,
the
who's the best. But it's the end of the quarter, so we decided, fuck that. So we're gonna so tonight we are doing our long form show. So it's basically like our other shit that we do, except it's longer and more fun. So the first game that we have for you today is a game called Deconstruction. And this is a game for, who is this a game for?
Veronica!
It's a game for Veronica. It's a game for Alexis. It's a game for Spencer and Kinsey. And the way that this game works, we are gonna start out with a two-person scene. We're gonna do a two-person scene, and they're kind of just gonna like riff a while and just talk about some things like in this universe. And then so basically this two-person scene is gonna like establish this world that they're gonna create, and then we're gonna see scenes later based on that, based on what was said in the original scene. And they're just gonna kind of build some stuff off of there, and it'll be a lot of fun. So we have Alexis and Spencer who are gonna start for us. Suggestion of anything at all.
More
chairs!
More chairs!
I heard mortuary. So your suggestion is mortuary, and this is deconstruction after one round of applause!
It's the day!
I'm sorry.
Thank you.
I saw her in the little box.
Yeah.
Oh, with that. And as is customary, I got you a cake because I'm one of the best people. No matter how bad it is, you get cake. You have to eat it now.
You know, I'm trying to do this whole weight loss thing since it's kind of
bad for me. You know, it's really, really common for people to just go on crazy diets when their relatives die. No, I'm just a bit insensitive.
I'm sorry.
Yeah.
It's that new Holden thing, right? The new Holden weight loss thing?
I haven't heard of the Holden weight loss thing, but...
Oh, the Holden weight loss thing is very common for sad people to do. As soon as you become sad, you cut out all carbs, all cake, and surprisingly all fruit. Just meat and vegetables.
I'm dieting. That sounds
good. That's a Holden's diet. You're on your own special diet, though.
Yeah, I'm on the Caulfield diet. It's where you eat just kind of like grains. All natural grains. Then, you know, if you want to eat meat, you can, but some people just like to go vegetarian.
You said the coffee diet, all you do is drink coffee.
That's not healthy.
Hey, we're talking about diets, we're not talking about healthy,
that's
right?
Statement. Wow, that's my
answer. I couldn't find the body, but that was very quick. Thank you.
I'm signing that she has been run over, and I can confirm that.
Yes, you're identifying her.
Okay. You know, she kind of raised me like she was my mom because my parents weren't really around.
That's very sad.
Yeah, and she always was trying to get me into fitness and stuff like that. And I feel like now that she's gone, I want to carry on her legacy of just health and wellness.
Health and wellness.
Health and wellness.
Oh, that's perfect. There's a new health and wellness center down the street.
Oh, really?
Yeah, and all it serves are different diets. Like, they don't even go. And they have the menu divided into all these diets we've been talking about. And everything you order from a certain part of the menu comes from that specific diet.
I'm so sorry. I know you really wanted to get into Harvard, and it's such a bummer. I didn't really know it was appropriate, but I got you with this cake pop. It's okay, like, take it here, you know?
What?
I just...
Whoosh!
Oh,
oh,
my
God. I know you wrote the drama thing, and I'm really sorry you didn't get into the grad school, but... Bag of Jolly Ranchers. Just the whole bag of Jolly Ranchers.
Thanks,
that
Dad.
Jolly.
Sure will.
Jolly the name.
Whoosh!
We've got the meeting out of the palm of our hands, Steve. We've sold them on all the diets. The only book they can read is Catcher in the Rye. I know that you've had this really excellent, fantastic, I'm gonna say,
thank you, Jimmy.
Excellent evil scheme. I just want you to know that the Holden and the Caulfield diet companies, they've actually turned full cult. So, they're actually like, it's kind of become like a gang rivalry on the streets. Now, I'm getting a little concerned about the safety of the community. So I was wondering if there's, you know, something new that we can introduce into the community to sort of, you know, like, cut some of that violence out, just see if...
Well, I'm right, old man, you're coming. We might have some good ideas.
Wilson,
you always...
Big brain, Wilson, and a dynamic duo. Don't know nothing without you, Wilson. As long as they can be, Wilson.
Sorry, I
didn't mean. No, the gang violence, well, that was the goal with the whole program. Yeah, we want violence on the street.
Anarchy!
And then the communist regime will rise.
I'm sorry. Caulfield died in a bus, am I right?
Keep it cool.
Carbiners!
Hey, you want to say that to my
No.
Alright, I understand you're from the Caulfields and the Holdens. Oh, but you don't need to be fighting with things like this. I tell you what. Come here. I got a little bit of espresso here. See, I'm on a coffee diet. That's
I don't think our love can ever be. Because you're from the Caulfields, and I'm from the Holdens.
I'll talk to your brother.
That'll be a great idea.
I know nothing about. I was open to talk a bit. I know we're on different diets.
What do you want to talk about? We're on different diets. Yeah, we are. Different sides of the street, different sides of the tracks, different sides of the.
I was hoping that maybe.
I read books, I watch movies.
I'm aware of
your
literacy.
I like donuts. You like cookies. Oh yeah, but we know you cheat. Don't pretend you don't. Don't pretend you got some.
Don't hurt him, Ernesto! Don't hurt him!
I'm gonna love you! Calm down! Jesus! Alright, look. You gonna love my little sister?
Yes.
You gonna take care of her?
Sure.
You gonna promise?
Never would.
You promise not to cheat on her with cookies?
My diet. is that a knife?
It's my
big brother, please. Big brother, don't do it. I love him, big brother.
Petunia, all I was gonna do with this book was educate you.
Oh God.
Look, it's a book on true love. I've been reading it, trying to open up my heart a little bit, trying to understand what my sister's been going through. And you know what? Opened up the old ticket here, and I say,
this person.
You two lovers, you found each other.
I'm really glad we didn't fake our deaths. Instead, we just talked all of this.
The Caulfields and the Holdens are getting soft. They're falling in love.
The coffee people are coming in.
Oh, those bastards!
Fucking it all up.
Yes, Janine. I'm sorry, do you mind if I just
go? Go on.
Just private meeting, Wilson. We'll take it first.
Boss, I've been noticing we've been issuing a lot more marriage certificates lately. And it's getting very exciting. It's seeming to break up some of the violence, bring a little bit more joy and love. But it's not what we want.
Oh.
It's not what we want. No!
Okay. Well. In other news, the coffee clans have been, you know, just going crazy.
I know, they're coffee all over the place. They're just parkouring over the whole city.
Yeah, stealing, you know, just breaking into coffee shops and stealing everything that's available to them.
And they're drinking more coffee, which just makes them more frantic and
right.
You know, I can hear everything you're saying.
Come on. Get over it. Just come on. Come on. Come on. So
the coffee.
Thought you could hear everything I said.
You heard all of it, so why are you asking?
No, I wasn't listening.
We really love our shop. Just Graham Shack.
Oh yeah, parkour, thanks!
That was our last espresso.
When I heard about the coffee diet, I thought, wow, this is the perfect time for us to open a coffee shop. Little did I know that everyone just took all our coffee.
Hey guys, I'm sorry. I normally deliver your coffee on Tuesdays, but my truck just got ransacked.
We don't pay for that. So just get more. This isn't our problem yet.
There is no more. It's all been stolen.
Oh. It's ruined. No more coffee.
Excuse me. I'm so sorry to interrupt. I see that I
have come at a bad time, but I just noticed that you've been having some trouble lately. Well, I own the tea shop down the street, and well, I haven't had a lot of business, but since you've had so much, I thought perhaps you could use my final, well, my final coffee pot. I usually
get the tea! Get the tea!
It wasn't quite business, it was actually more along the line of fevering. Thank you so much.
Oh, man, yeah, we haven't been making any money.
Have a nice day.
Whoosh! Oh my God.
Okay, I got it. The big idea.
Come on!
Coffee. Prohibition.
Jeez!
You work so well with alcohol. You gotta do it with coffee.
It's gonna work without coffee.
It'll be illegal.
Take it to the streets.
We can arrest them officially.
You were on drugs. Historical thing that have worked.
Mayor, do you mind fighting? Mayor Dennis.
So I don't actually have anything important to tell you. I just want to make sure our lunch plans are confirmed. Wilson is not invited, right? No, we're not invited. He can't hear us right.
I'm listening this time. That hurts.
For every single grade. This is the eighth time I read it for second grade, and for third grade, and for all the grades leading up to the grade I currently am in.
This is the way things are.
Banning other books is dumb.
Sander, you know, you're such a dreamer. People like you are in charge.
I don't know. I have a ton of teen angst from having to repeatedly read.
Well, if you run for mayor, can I be your campaign manager? Probably not a vote for you, but why don't we just give it a try?
Xander for mayor. I like
Xander for mayor! Are you running for mayor?
I am running for mayor. We'll be banning Catcher in the Rye and making it so people can only read Love in the Time of Cholera.
Oh, I'm so sick of these people trying to make new rules. I think I should run for mayor.
Yeah.
And the only book we're allowed to read is Catcher in the Rye. Am I right? That's a good book.
It means so much for me to be here with you guys.
Aww. Good to have you here too, Wilson.
Of course we do.
Cool, well, I got you guys something.
Hey, are you the mayor?
Yes, Mayor Dennis.
Well, you got some competition coming.
Two children?
Is this a democracy we're running?
No! Anarchy! I told you right away that was
that. Oh, I don't know about that.
I feel like the public's getting a little confused.
Yeah.
Perhaps we should do something about it.
Switch the book?
different book.
Well, I feel like that could appease the masses.
I got it.
Perhaps.
The Bible.
Basically translates to is we are going
going to do a long form, and it's going to take place in one location that has 1,000 rooms. So examples would be like a hospital or IKEA or someplace that has lots and lots of mini locations. So I need a suggestion from you guys for a location.
Right.
This is my fourth time on the train this week.
All right.
I'm a regular customer here.
Okay, Gilbert. How many orange slices?
4.
Okay. Just the water?
Yes.
There's the orange slices. What brings you on our luxury train today?
I'm going to visit my granddaughter.
Oh, how nice.
Hello, do you want a cake?
This is the complimentary cake we give to all of our guests.
Well, then why haven't I gotten it before?
It's new.
I'll have it, I guess.
He wants the cake.
Whoosh! To the smoking car! Woo!
Yeah! A lovely Saturday on the train, if I do say so myself.
A little windy outside.
It's a bit breezy, yes.
The winds look like it's moving to the northeast and the southeast today.
I know. Oh, Calipity. We haven't done one of our little shams in so long.
Oh, Bartolomeo, oh, how dare you say that?
Oh, you know that was a torrid affair and it could never happen again.
Shut up. Shut your damn mouth. Shut your smoke-filled mouth right now. I'm going to tell you right now. Arnold, what?
What you did with the underwear luggage.
See,
I couldn't find it in our
car. Arnold, did you check the second car?
I checked it.
Oh, God damn it, Arnold. We went on this trip.
I found an errant luggage from that.
Oh, thank you so much.
I'm sorry, I stole your underwear.
A train fountain.
It's so romantic, Reginald.
Yes. Yes, I just thought it'd be a lovely spot for our honeymoon.
Oh, yes.
For our third honeymoon, I should say. We've been married for 29 years. You know, the time seems to never pass when I'm with you, and so
oh,
I just thought
yes. I feel as young as a small young bunny.
Just like when we first met 29 years ago. Like,
oh yes.
You know, we hastened into this marriage.
Oh yes.
I thought it would never last.
But it did.
I thought it would never last.
It's worked brilliantly. We should write a book. We should write a book on how we stay so in love.
I think we should, you know, we should go to the train library. There's lots of inspiration there.
Oh yes, we should. Something
there.
And you're bullshit to the playground on the train.
Hi!
humans.
And what is your last name?
Winkies.
And nothing for you, darling.
Samuel.
Well, just Samuel, don't
Ah, sure, until you woke me up.
You dream about your future and things that you want to do.
Yeah, I'm hoping to get a nice steak when we start.
Look, it's the first star of the evening. You can wish for your steak on it if you want.
Yeah.
Move to the observatory. The stars never stay in place. I thought this would be a lot more informative than it is.
Loose to the janitor's closet!
Loose to a cabin!
Once upon a time, there were two Billy Goat Scruff.
Did I get it right?
I was asking for your imagination. Oh,
ma'am. Where's Mom? God, she's always off scheming.
I
lost my soft luggage again. Why do I always lose my luggage?
Now, Sonny, I think it's being stolen.
Oh, that makes a lot of sense. Why do I always have to pack so many extras of my undergarments?
Well, just because...
I'm sweaty.
Those winds are going to the south. He said, Clippity, you hear me? I feel like there's trouble in the brewing.
Yes, we should have known. When the winds blow to the south, it can only mean one thing.
Robbery! Robbery on the train. We must take her.
Did I just see out of my side eye?
Bartholomew, why isn't this the Rumpus has taken all the power now? What? We gotta get back in business, come on.
You and I.
All right.
Bandito!
Banditos forever. See you on the other side, my
friend. Yep.
Whoosh to the safe room. Court.
Yeah, Bort?
There's a couple other banditos on this train.
Oh, man.
Wart! Wart, I work on this train. Just restocking all the safes. Okay. Got more in the safes.
Hey, Wart.
Hey, we can do that for you.
We can do it. I was over stroking the fire. Stroking them.
We're good at stroking the fire.
My hands are burnt to a crisp from my passion. Stroke them all.
Whatever you do in your own.
I'm sure it looks like there's trouble over the engines.
Yeah, you might want to go check it out. We got this.
We got this.
All.
I think I'm about done.
Whoosh! To the dining room. The lights are all out. So, this is where I work. I thought we could have a date here.
I brought a couple of patties, just in case. Here's your patty, extra seasoned as you like it.
Thank you.
You know, when you're a little scared, just toss it around in your hand. Just toss it around. See, I'm just a little nervous because I've just been so excited to
go. Yeah.
It's okay. I'll marry you.
And also a bag of meat.
Where is the cake this time?
Ah!
Hi, Dad. With this meat, you must just
Worst
put it
to the train chapel. Matt, this is your wedding game in about 30 seconds. Oh, you're welcome to watch.
Oh, could
you're
I?
Welcome to watch.
I just came to pray, but I love weddings.
Oh,
I'm worried about the weather this wedding. I thought I had the Bible, but this is just a copy of Catch Over.
Shuffling captain. So, if you guys didn't know, I'm graduating, but also I'm staying here next year to do a graduate program. So, but I'm gonna be doing grad school, so I don't know if I'm gonna have time to do captain stuff. But Becca does,
so she's coming back up to be a captain.
A sad graduating boy.
Yeah.
So I will no longer be a captain, which means we need a new captain, a brand spanking new captain. And that new captain is Nicholas Caicedo. So we're going to end tonight by letting Nick host his first game as live news.
I'm gonna host a rousing game of Sex is Like, my favorite educational game where we learn about things that sex is like. Suggestions about things.
Potatoes!
Sometimes they just hurt way worse than anything else, and you know, and then you bleed all over the place, and then you scream profanities, and then, you know, you're just really mad about how much pain you're going through.
Sex is like paper cuts, because I never mean to get it, but then it happens.
Sex is like paper cuts. I never know when they're going to happen, but then when they do, I'm just kind of disappointed.
More things!
Caterpillar!
Ladybugs?
Sex is like ladybugs.
I like them.
Sometimes you're not allowed to close your mouth.
What's it?
This is like going to the dentist. There's just a lot of things going on in my mouth. I don't have a lot of control over what's going on.
Going to the dentist, you're always like kind of embarrassed about the personal hygiene things that you should have done before.
Going to the dentist, you shouldn't be talking during the experience.
Sex is like going to the dentist. Sometimes it's really painful and you bleed a lot. Sex is like going to the dentist. Sometimes I like to close my eyes and pretend I'm not there.
Sex is like going to the dentist. There's a lot of like drilling involved and like machinery. And it hurts a lot.
Roll a little bit?
Sex is like going to the dentist. He always wears a mask.
Sex is like going to the dentist. It is highly overpriced.
Defining factor of my childhood.
Sex is like Hot Wheels because everyone thinks boys like them more, but that's not true. Yeah! Thank you guys so much for coming out tonight. We have one more.
10? At 11? What is it, 2? 10 or 11?
Check the Facebooks for that. And thank you all for coming out!
Bye!